الشيخ حفظه الله mentioned that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم any from his sunan from his ways is that like the hadith of ثوبان رضي الله عنه وأرضاه that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم when he make the taslim he will make three istighfar he will make three istighfar and then he will say Allahumma anta as-salam wa minka as-salam tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. So here this is what is to be starting with first, which is the istighfar. Amma understanding the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, as Imam Bukhari rahimahullah brought it about, that we used to know the end point of the salah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with takbirat. And that takbirat is not to mean that you say Allahu Akbar, but as the hadith of Thawban here mentioned, is that you say Astaghfirullah thalatha marrat, you say Astaghfirullah three times. So from that, Barakallahu Fikum, the Shaykh Hafidhahullah is coming back to how to make the adhkar from the beginning, meaning after the salah, all the way to the end of the adhkar. What is the proper sequence to take? He say, فَإِذَا سَلَّمْنَا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ نَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ ثَلَاثًا. And this is in page number 81. He say, if the third paragraph, the beginning of the third paragraph or the fourth paragraph from the asterisk, he say, فَإِذَا سَلَّمْنَا, if we make the taslim min as-salah, from the salah, he say, نَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ ثَلَاثًا, we say astaghfirullah three times. And after that, we will say, Allahumma anta as-salam, wa minka as-salam, tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. So after the istighfar, these are the words to be said. Allahumma anta as-salam, wa minka as-salam, tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. Thumma naqulu, after that, we will say, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا ينفع ذي الجد منك الجد. And he mentioned here that is to be said right after the person say اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام إلى آخر. ثم نقول لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ولا نعبد إلا إياه له النعم وله الفضل وله الثناء الحسنة. And this is what is to be said. Abdullah, sit down. Sit down. And then we will say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ولا نعبد إلا إياه له النعم وله الفضل وله الثناء الحسنة لا إله إلا الله مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. And if we all يعني pay a little close attention to these words, they are all words of reaffirming the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are all sentences or phrases that are showing the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala في أولوهيته, showing the oneness of Allah, that He is the only one deserving to be worshipped. Showing that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deserving for all types of acts of worship. And then one is also freeing himself from the ways of the disbelievers. When he mentioned, وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ, even if it is displeasing to the disbelievers, that you are upon that which is لا إله إلا الله مخلصين له الدين, that all your religion, it is purely for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And after that, ثم نسبح لله ثلاثا وثلاثين. And then after that, we will be glorifying Allah. We'll be glorifying Allah. ما معنى التسبيح؟ ما معنى التسبيح؟ What is the meaning of سبحان الله؟ What is the meaning of Subhanallah? Naam, what should I say? Right, that's the literal translation from Arabic to English. But what is the meaning of saying, glory to Allah, or glorify be He, Allah, Hassan? What is the meaning of glory be He, Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Baka? Huh? Umar? Aba Munira? Ahsanta. It is freeing Allah. Hassan, write it. Subhanallah. So when a person making the dhikr saying Subhanallah, they are freeing Allah. Your statement is that you are freeing Allah from any type of imperfection, from any type of nuqsan, from any type of imperfection. Not fi dhatihi, wala fi af'alihi. Not in his essence, nor in his actions. Not in his actions, nor in his essence. That you are free in Allah from any type of imperfection. طيب. Ash. Right. Right. What does it mean?
It means that, you know, that, you know, these ones, he was missing that, you know, I am not capable of glorifying you as you should be glorified. That no matter how much tasbih we do, when we say subhanAllah, we are not capable of glorifying.
That's a different issue. That's the difference. We're talking about the ta'rif of tasbih, the meaning of tasbih. Without a doubt, nobody can glorify Allah the way that Allah is to be glorified. But we got to understand what is to glorify Allah. Because a person can be saying subhanAllah all their lives, but believing that Allah is everywhere. Have they glorified Allah the way He is to be glorified? La. Or a person can be believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resemble the creation, hasha lillah. Is he glorifying Allah? La. So therefore it is to understand, barakallahu feekum, that which we're saying. That's why Imam Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab, what did he say? Babu al-ilm, qabla al-qawli wal-amal, having knowledge before speech and actions. A person can, barakallahu feekum, claim to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Can claim to love the Prophet. But if he is in opposition of his sunnah, look, his claim is fake, is aneous, is wrong, it's just a claim. Right? So therefore, barakallahu fikum, saying a word and understanding a word is two different things. And it is important for us to, when we say, we understand it. So when a person says subhanallah, then he should never believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mixed with his creation. He should not believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is wrong in his creation. He should not believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is oppressing his creation. So he is removing any type of deficiency to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the meaning of saying subhanallah. So he mentioned, hafidhahullah, in regard to the statement to be said is that he will glorify Allah, meaning saying subhanallah 33 times. And he will say alhamdulillah at-tahmid thumma nahmaduhu 33, and we will praise Allah. We will say alhamdulillah. Now we ask the same question, ma ma'ana alhamdulillah? What is the meaning of saying alhamdulillah? What is the meaning of saying alhamdulillah? Shuf, you say subhanallah. Fihi ma'ana. Likewise, when you say alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah has a meaning too. Muhammad. Right, that it is that you are affirming. You are affirming the completion in his attributes. Both from his that and from his actions. That you are affirming the completeness of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Both from his essence and from his actions. So when you look at Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah, right? You have what, Khalil? You have what? And I'm coming to this hadith. Yes, Umar. Meaning, yes, the opposite meaning. Huh? Right, but put it in here, Muhammad. Ahsanta. You have negation and affirmation. You have negation, right? Because here, when you say Subhanallah, meaning that you are negating every type of imperfection to Allah. And when you say Alhamdulillah, you are affirming all types of completion to Allah, completeness to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. That's why the hadith say, Alhamdulillah, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, tamla'ani al-mizan. That Subhanallah wa bihamdihi fills their scales. Fills the scales. Yes. An-Nafi, saying Subhanallah is that you are making an-Nafi لِجَمِيعُ النُّقْسَانِ وَقَوْلُكَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ تُثْبِتُ لِلَّهِ صِفَةُ الْكَمَالِ huh? Right, النَّفِي وَالْإِثْبَاتِ. And when you say لا إله إلا الله, which is بارك الله فيكم, that which is that the person gonna complete. طيب, لا إله إلا الله has what? النَّفِي وَالْإِثْبَاتِ. So the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he say, after that we will say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, and we say Allahu Akbar, 33, wa naqulu tamaman al-mi'ah, and we'll complete it to be 100. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamdu, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in regard to this statement? Adam? Another one? Bakayoko? You're a little far. I can't hear you. Come on up close a little bit. No, not on that, saying that statement. I'm talking about that statement. You should see. No, that's that statement. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lahu al-mulku wa al-hamdu ala kulli shayin qadir. Just that statement.
Whoever say with firmness in his heart, yaqeen in his heart.
No, that's la ilaha illallah. Man qala la ilaha illallah mustayqinan fi qalbihi. Not that, the whole statement. About Musa? No, no. Right, that's correct too. That's correct too. But the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, the best I was given, me and the prophets before, was la ilaha illallah. وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. And then he say خير الدعاء دعاء عرفة. خير الدعاء دعاء العرفة. The best of the supplication is the supplication of عرفة. And the best I was given and the prophets before me was the statement, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. So that shows, barakallahu fihim, the virtue of this statement. But what is important, is this just to al-alfaz, al-nutq bil-alfaz faqat? Dun al-fahm wal-imtithal ma fihi min al-amr wal-nahi? Is that what is important, just to say it, la? But rather understanding what is the meaning of la ilaha illallah. Wahdahu la sharika lah. Lahul mulk wa lahul hamd. Wahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. What is important is, barakallahu fikum, before saying it, is to, walhamdulillah, know what you're saying. Ma'a at-tadabburi, while you are